Parish Feast Day. Theme is towards a synodal parish. The parish is no longer the primary gathering and social center. Pope Francis said, a renewed parish is a site for synodality and synodal formation. The pastoral team can begin to define concrete goals that it seeks to achieve in the parish synodal experience. It can begin with reflecting on the parish's strengths, charism, and areas of growth. It can continue with listening to parishioners in surveys and through dialogues in town hall meeting to discern the most pressing pastoral needs. After envisioning the goals, the parish team develops signposts that name destination on the synodal path. For example, one goal may simply be to affirm and celebrate the reality that the parish includes members who come from different ethnicities, backgrounds, and life experiences, who hold different theological, political, and other ideological views. Another goal may be to acknowledge and celebrate the reality that amid these differences, we trust that the Holy Spirit continues to knit the parish together in unity. Let's pray that we, the parishioners, along with our authorities of the parish, of Deanery, and of the Archdiocese, continue to bring the mission of Jesus alive in reality.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
We gather together to celebrate the parish feast in honor of Saint Francis of Assisi, our patron. Truly, his life inspires us, as it did right at that time in the 12th century. Saint Francis wanted to follow the Lord radically, to follow the gospel in totality. And many were attracted and drawn towards this way of life. He died at the age of 45, and yet his life had such a great impact on people at that time in the 12th century and even today. As we celebrate our feast, we are invited to draw closer to God and to draw closer to people. That is the theme also of our reflection on the synod, of gathering together as one people. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us give praise to God in the words of the Gloria.
Praise.
us pray. O God, by whose gift Saint Francis was conformed to Christ in poverty and humility, grant that by walking in Francis's footsteps, we may follow your Son, and through joyful charity, come to be united with you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the second book of Kings. In those days, Naaman the Syrian went down and dipped himself 7 times in the Jordan, according to the word of the man of God. And his flesh was restored like the flesh of a little child, and he was clean. Then he returned to the man of God, he and all his company, and he came and stood before him, and he said, "Behold, I know that there is no God in all the earth but in Israel. So accept now a present from your servant." But he said, "As the Lord lives, before whom I stand, I will receive none." And he urged him to take it, but he refused. Then Naaman said, "If not, please let there be given to your servant 2 mule loads of earth. For from now on, your servant will not offer burnt offering or sacrifice to any god but the Lord." The word of the Lord. Our response is, the Lord has shown his deliverance to the nations. Altogether, the Lord has shown his deliverance to the nations. Oh, sing a new song to the Lord, for he has worked wonders. His right hand and his holy arm have brought salvation. Response: the Lord has shown his deliverance to the nations. The Lord has made known his salvation, has shown his deliverance to the nations. He has remembered his merciful love and his truth for the house of Israel. Response: the Lord has shown his deliverance to the nations. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God. Shout to the Lord, all the earth. Break forth into joyous song and sing out your praise. Response: the Lord has shown his deliverance to the nations.
A reading from the second letter of Saint Paul to Timothy. Beloved, remember Jesus Christ, risen from the dead, the offspring of David, as preached in my gospel, for which I am suffering, bound with chains as a criminal. But the word of God is not bound. Therefore, I endure everything for the sake of the elect, that they also may obtain the salvation that is in Christ Jesus with eternal glory. The same is trustworthy, for if we have died with him, we will also live with him. If we endure, we will also reign with him. If we deny him, he will also deny us. If we are faithless, he remains faithful, for he cannot deny himself. The word of the Lord. Kindly stand for the gospel.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the way to Jerusalem, Jesus was passing along between Samaria and Galilee. And as he entered a village, he was met by 10 lepers who stood at a distance and lifted up their voices, saying, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." When he saw them, he said to them, "Go and show yourselves to the priests." And as they went, they were cleansed. Then one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice, and he fell on his face at Jesus' feet, giving him thanks. Now, he was a Samaritan. Then Jesus answered, "Were not 10 cleansed? Where are the 9? Was no one found to return and give praise to God except this foreigner?" And he said to him, "Rise and go your way. Your faith has made you well." The Gospel of the Lord. In the weeks after the Bandra feast, we have a number of parishes coming there to the Mount as a whole parish or a particular organization, associations, on a pilgrimage. They come to express their devotion to our Blessed Mother. They come to thank the Lord for all His blessings. They do so right through the year too. But when they come on a pilgrimage, they come together as a group. And that act of devotion, that act of pilgrimage, reminds us of what we are reflecting on today. Drawing closer to God and drawing closer to people. Whenever we make that pilgrimage or we climb up the mount, it requires a little effort on our part.
in order to be able to encounter the Lord. And that is required of us as disciples, to draw closer to the Lord. But we will see through the readings of today that while we make that effort to draw closer to God, God comes to meet us. God comes to be close to us. And we see this in the readings of today, in the healing of these persons who were suffering from leprosy. We are told of Naaman the Syrian, who wanted to be cured by the prophet Elisha, and he is told to bathe 7 times in the river Jordan, and he is cured. A similar situation is described for us in the gospel passage from Luke chapter 17, of 10 persons from suffering from leprosy who cry out to Jesus. We are told they stand at a distance away and they cry out to Jesus. And the Lord Jesus hears their plea and heals them. The Lord invites them, therefore, to be part of the worshiping community. Because of their situation, of the disease that they were suffering from, they were cut off from the rest of society. They could not interact with people. They had to stay far away. They were isolated. They were marginalized. But now the Lord Jesus heals them and brings them into communion with society. And then he tells them, go and show yourself to the priest, because then they would be allowed to join in public worship. And so they are integrated now. They are united with God. They are united with the whole believing community. They draw closer to God. They draw closer also to one another. The barriers are broken and they can once again be one with all the people. That happens with Naaman. That happens with the 10 persons suffering from leprosy. There is an interesting insight that we gain from today's gospel, that one of those persons returned to thank the Lord. Just one of those 9. We are told also that Naaman came back to thank the prophet Elisha and he wanted to give him gifts. This one person suffering from leprosy who came back to thank Jesus, we are told, was a Samaritan. Now, being a person suffering from leprosy, he was cut off. He had a barrier that had to be overcome, which the Lord Jesus helps him to overcome. But there was a double barrier also, because being a Samaritan, he was despised by the Jews. And yet he comes back to thank the Lord. His act of gratitude leads him still closer to God. He recognizes who Jesus is. And at the end of the passage, Jesus tells him, your faith has made you well. He recognized that Jesus had not only the power to heal him of his disease of leprosy, but Jesus had the power to save him from sin and death. That Jesus was the Messiah and he could place his faith in Jesus. And so he, because of his act of thanksgiving, he comes even closer to God. He receives a deep spiritual insight into who Jesus is. The ones who did not thank Jesus, Jesus doesn't take back from them the gift. He healed them and they remain healed. God does not take back his gifts. He gives generously. As our second reading tells us, even if we are not faithful, God is faithful. And so Jesus poured out his gift of healing on those 10. The 9 who did not come back did not receive that additional insight of discovering Jesus as the Messiah, as that one. And therefore we are invited, as we draw closer to the Lord, we pour before him all our requirements, our needs, our petitions. We are invited also to thank the Lord, to thank the Lord for all his blessings. And then we will receive even deeper insights. We will draw even closer to the Lord. As we seek to draw closer to God, God comes closer to us. Our readings of today therefore remind us, drawing closer to God, and as we see, the people now were integrated once again with the rest of the community. They were one with the rest of the worshipping people. We see these same aspects in the life of Saint Francis of Assisi too. Drawing closer to God and drawing closer to people. He could have had all the luxuries of life as the son of a wealthy silk merchant. He was a successful knight. And then came this moment of realization. There is something more to life. God was calling him closer to himself. And Francis of Assisi realized that he had to give up everything, all the barriers that were preventing him from reaching closer to God. And for him, it was his possessions and his wealth. And he said, this is the barrier, an obstacle. And God helps him with his grace to get rid of that. And he draws closer to Christ. He follows Jesus totally and completely. And with him, so many others were also attracted to follow the Lord. Saint Francis was able to draw close to Christ, but he wanted everyone else to also come close to Christ. And while we know that Saint Francis lived this life of radical poverty, of simplicity, of humility, of joyful spirituality, one of the special characteristics of Francis of Assisi was that he was the one who invited people to make the crib at Christmas, to make that representation of the child Jesus born in a cave and there lying in simplicity. And his purpose was precisely this. He says, we must realize that God comes close to us, that in the incarnation, in the birth of Jesus, God is taking that step to become one of us and being near to us. And therefore Saint Francis wanted people to experience the nearness of God, that God is with us in every situation. And so we thank the Lord for this wonderful witness of Saint Francis as he invites us to draw closer to God, reminding us also that Jesus comes to be in our midst. We see Francis also as a model of drawing closer to people. He sought to be one with everyone, to embrace and to love every person. We know that beautiful incident of his where he embraces the person suffering from leprosy and he says, bitterness turned to sweetness. At that moment he realized the grace of God. He realized that everyone is a child of God. He sought to break all divisions. He has that beautiful prayer, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring love, and so on. He wanted to break all barriers, all divisions. We know that even during the time of the Crusades, when there was battle and war going on between Christians and Muslims, Francis of Assisi goes to meet the Sultan and he says, I'm looking for peace. I want to be an agent of peace. He tried. He made his efforts to seek reconciliation and oneness, to acknowledge the failings of those who were promoting violence. He was a man of peace, of bringing people together, of overcoming barriers. We thank the Lord for Saint Francis of Assisi, our patron, and he invites us to draw closer to God, to draw closer to people. This is also the theme that you have been reflecting on in these last days of the Novena. The Synod is an invitation to each one of us as members of the Church to draw closer to God. But our spirituality is not an individual spirituality. I am only concerned about myself and I want to grow in holiness and I want to grow closer to God. Yes, we are responsible for our individual salvation. Yes, we must make our efforts, but not just as one single person, all together, as a community, as a parish, as a church, we journey together. And that is the meaning of the word synod. It is drawn from two Greek words, syn and hodos. Syn, S-Y-N, meaning together. And hodos, the way. In other words, together on the way. Walking together towards God. On a pilgrimage, on a journey towards God. And therefore, the Synod is an invitation precisely to listen to one another, to walk together, to share our lives, to strengthen each other in faith. And surely during these 9 days, you have reflected on various themes of the Synod. during the synod discussions in June. There were a two-day diocesan level synod, and over there four themes were highlighted. We must be an inclusive church. That means we must welcome everyone as part of the church. There should be no discrimination, no prejudices, no barriers between Christians. All of us are called to be one body in Christ. And so we seek to be an inclusive church, welcoming all, especially those who are on the periphery, those who are neglected, those who find life difficult. A second theme that was expressed is that we are to be a collaborative church, that we need to cooperate together, that each one puts before the others his or her talents and says, I'm ready to do this. God has blessed me with this talent. I can offer this help to the church. And so we seek to be a collaborative church, taking responsibility for our church and saying, yes, we want to walk together. We will join hands with all people. We will give away, we will overcome barriers. We will not be an inward-looking church, but we will look around and see how we can help. Thirdly, we are to be a faith-filled church, drawing closer to God, drawing strength from Him, even as we realize that God comes close to us, that He comes to meet us in Jesus. And so at the synod meeting, it was expressed that we need to have adult faith formation. While we have formation for the children through their Sunday school and preparation for First Holy Communion, preparation for confirmation, we need also to continue our catechesis right through, so that all of us, besides the Sunday homily, have opportunities to grow in our knowledge of Scripture, in the teachings of the Church, in our prayer, in our life of drawing closer to God. And so we are to be a faith-filled church. And finally, to be a church relevant to the times of today. To be able to see what are the problems around in society. To use the social media to communicate the good news. To be able to guide all our people. And to listen to the cries of the environment. These are issues of people around us. These will help us to respond to the situations and the problems of today. And so we ask for the grace that we continue this journey together. The synod, it is not yet over. We have completed it only at the diocesan level. Now they will have a discussion, synods, at the national level. Once that paper has been submitted now, it will then go to the Asian or the continental level. And finally, next year in 2023, Pope Francis will have the universal synod for the whole church, once again reflecting on this theme of being a people walking together, drawing closer to each other as we draw closer to God. May Saint Francis of Assisi, our patron, help us to draw closer to God and to all people. Saint Francis, in fact, was able to even interact with the creatures of creation. He could talk to animals and birds. He was one with the whole of creation. For him, there were no boundaries, no barriers. We may not be able to reach that level of communion with everyone, but let us begin by being one with those around us as we draw closer to the Lord. And let us remember the message of today's gospel, to be thankful to the Lord for all His blessings. That even as we have our difficulties and struggles and we ask the Lord to help us in these situations, God continues to bless us abundantly. In the Eucharist, the celebrant will say, lift up your hearts. And you say, we have lifted them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is proper, it is right, it is just to give thanks to God. Today on this feast of our parish, let us lift up our hearts in thanksgiving to God. May Saint Francis intercede for us that we will be truly a synodal parish, a synodal church. Kindly stand as we profess our faith in God, the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Prayer of the Faithful. Let us present to the Lord our petitions on this feast day of Saint Francis of Assisi, as we thank the Lord for all the blessings, and we seek to draw closer to Him and closer to people. Our response: Lord, receive our prayer. Together,
Lord, receive our prayer. For the Church, may our prayer be constant, encouraging a more united world, hoping for a flourishing of justice and peace. We ask this in Jesus' name. Lord, receive our prayer. For the world and all in need of daily bread, touch the hearts of those who live with abundance, to share more freely and give more compassionately. We ask in Jesus' name, Lord, receive our prayer. For a spiritual renewal in all our lives, may we discover new directions and renewed energy. May truth and integrity help us to act with higher standards. May our worship be meaningful. We ask this in Jesus' name.
Lord, receive our prayer.
Provide safety for all who travel and guidance to those who are away from home. May every country treat immigrants humanly. Bless those serving in the military or in the missions. We ask this in Jesus' name.
Lord, receive our prayer.
For the needs we offer in silence, for our beloved sick, addicted, dying, and grieving. We ask this in Jesus' name.
Lord, receive our prayer.
We pray in silence for our personal needs. We ask this in Jesus' name.
Lord, receive our prayer.
Heavenly Father, hear the prayers that we have placed before You in deep faith. You pour out gifts upon us far greater than what we asked or what we imagine. Grant these through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For offertory, kindly join in singing hymn number 378. Hymn number 378.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. As we bring you these offerings, O Lord, we pray that we might be rightly disposed for the celebration of the mystery of the cross, which Saint Francis so ardently embraced. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you are praised in the company of your saints, and in crowning their merits, you crown your own gifts. By their way of life, you offer us an example. By communion with them, you gave us companionship. By their intercession, sure support, so that encouraged by so great a cloud of witnesses, we may run as victors in the race before us and win with them the imperishable crown of glory through Christ our Lord. And so with the angels and archangels and with the great multitude of the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
We make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all your saints, Saint Francis of Assisi, our patron, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Oswald, our Bishop, John Rodrigues, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world.
Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
For communion, kindly join in singing hymn number 40 from the Yellow Pages, hymn number 40.
Pick me up.
Kindly stand for the prayer after communion. Grant us, we pray, O Lord, through these holy gifts which we have received, that imitating the charity and apostolic zeal of Saint Francis, we may experience the effects of your love and spread them everywhere for the salvation of all. Through Christ our Lord. Please be seated.
Notices for the week. We celebrate today our parish feast, the feast of Saint Francis of Assisi, our parish patron saint, in the 28th Sunday of Ordinary Time. There will be no evening mass as announced earlier. The relic of Blessed Carlos Acutis, as announced earlier, will be brought to our church on the 19th, 20th, and the 21st of October. All the youth of our parish are expected to be present in large numbers for this occasion. Further details will be communicated later. The Catholic Charismatic Renewal is celebrating their Golden Jubilee on the 23rd of October at Sri Shanmukhananda Hall. Kindly pray for the successful Jubilee celebrations. Professional filmmaking course at St. Paul's Institute of Communication Center, Bandra, beginning October 2022 till March 2023. Kindly refer the details forwarded in our respective Assisi WhatsApp groups for further details. In the month of October, we observe the month of the Rosary. We have recitation of the rosaries in our own homes and in our respective Assisi. Those who need the statue of Our Lady may kindly contact our parish office. Meetings in our parish. There will be no Sunday school today, no altar servers meeting today. Month's Mind Mass for the soul of Rosie Pereira on Tuesday, the 11th of October at 7 p.m. The parish fathers will start visiting all our parishioners house to house as cluster-wise in each Assisi of our parish. We will make an announcement every week, the day, time, and the areas of our visits to our parishioners' homes before our weekly family visits. There will be no discussion of this issue or any matters of the parish or of any individuals. It is purely a pastoral as well as spiritual for the well-being of all our parishioners. So, kindly respect the purpose of this pastoral visits of our parish fathers. Collection from last Sunday, the 2nd of October, was ₹15,548. For Franciscan outreach collection on the 2nd of October was ₹6,595. Thank you for your generous contribution. End of the notices.
On behalf of our parish priest, Father Christopher, and myself, Father Joel Fernandez, we extend our heartfelt gratitude to His Lordship, Bishop John Rodrigues, for coming and gracing this occasion, for being the main celebrant for our parish priest. Thank you.
At this moment, I thank some of our parents there, especially the BBC members and the members of the Chair Committee, the members of all service and associations for helping throughout this Novena days and especially for this feast day also. I thank also the coordinators and animators of various Assisi for the liturgical preparation, like organizing the choir, lectures, and conducting the homily every day after the Novena. And especially today, the Parish Sunday School and the members of SFO for grief and preparing the Parish Feast Day liturgy. We also thank all our altar service for all the days of Novena, their services, and especially today for the Parish Feast. Especially they have gone through the kind of practices practically every day in the late evening. So we thank all our altar service for their support and effort. We thank also our extraordinary Eucharist directors for their services during the Novena and especially today also. We thank Celestine, our sacristan, and Michael, our helper, for the number of days of various help and support. There are also some of the donors and well-wishers behind the scenes. We remember their gratitude for their help. And I thank you, our parishioners, for your collaboration and cooperation in all the days of Novena, where we have Assisi wise preparing the liturgy and celebrating the Eucharist Novena celebration. I thank all the youth for their support throughout their liturgical preparation during their Novena time, especially for the food stall we had put up today. And all the citizen associations also I thank on behalf of our Parish Council and Father Joel Fernandez. Once again, I thank our Lordship Bishop John Rodrigues for his continuous support for us in a spiritual way and certainly praying for us during this Parish Feast Mass. And I thank the St. Paul's Institute for their support for live streaming of this Parish Feast Eucharist. I thank Father Johnny and the team. And I thank Father Renaud for having come here not only for the Novena and also joined this for the Parish Feast. Thank you. God bless you. As we sing together, I shall join the same tune. Can you stand and we greet each other and all together?
Happy Feast Day to us.
Happy Feast Day
to us. Happy Feast Day.
Thank you, Fathers Joel and Father Christopher, for your kind words. When Father Christopher asked me to come and celebrate the Mass, the Feast Mass, I said, I came last year. He said, no, it was online. You didn't meet the people. I said, I came before that in 2019. He said, no, you know our people so well. And then it struck me what one of the priests had told me in the past from St. Francis of Assisi. He says, at the Mount, when you all have your Novena and Feast, our church is completely empty. Everybody, all our parishioners are there. So we thank God for all of you, for your love and devotion to our Blessed Mother and your participation here in the life of the parish. May our patron, St. Francis of Assisi, continue to guide you and guide of all of us as we seek to grow in God's ways. A happy feast to all of you, dear parishioners. A special mention of the SFO, those dedicated to St. Francis and seeking to live more closely the life of St. Francis. May he continue to inspire each one of you and may God bless all your families. Happy feast once again.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Your response will be Amen. May Almighty God bless you in His kindness and pour out saving wisdom upon you. Amen. May He nourish you always with the teachings of the faith and make you persevere in holy deeds. May He turn your steps towards Himself and show you the path of charity and peace. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God.
For the recessional hymn, kindly join in singing hymn number 4 from the Yellow Pages. Hymn number 4.